Starting with a flask of cells grown to confluency, remove the media and add media containing exosome-free FBS in order to avoid the exosomes present in fetal bovine serum. A less expensive and still viable option is using low serum media. Serum-free media is even acceptable for a shorter culture time of about 12 hours. Using a smaller volume of media can also reduce the volume of reagent needed. Incubate for 24 to 48 hours based on the doubling time of cells. After incubation, move the conditioned media from the flask to a centrifuge tube. Centrifuge at 2000 G for 30 minutes to remove any cells or debris. Transfer the supernatant into a new centrifuge tube without disturbing the pellet. Add a half volume of total exosome isolation reagent and mix thoroughly by vortexing or pipetting up and down until the mixture is homogeneous. Then incubate the mixture at 4 degrees Celsius overnight. Make a small mark on the centrifuge tube lid and bottle. Place this mark up in the centrifuge to indicate where the pellet will form. Centrifuge at 10,000 G and 4 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Next, aspirate off the supernatant. Use the mark on the bottle to carefully avoid the pellet, as it will most likely not be visible. Resuspend the pellet in a small volume of PBS, between 100 to 200 microliters. This is important for keeping the exosomes concentrated. Transfer the small volume of exosomes to a microcentrifuge tube. The exosomes are now ready for quantification and use in experiments. Exosomes can be quantified using a micro-BCA protein assay. Only 2 microliters from the original sample diluted with PBS to 150 microliters are necessary. Remember, the concentration found from this dilution will be 75 times smaller than the original sample. 5 to 10 micrograms per milliliter is the standard concentration for exosome treatments per well in an experiment. Quantification is important to ensure isolation was successful and treatments are in the standard concentration range. All exosome treatments should be set against controls with PBS additions of equal volume. Exosomes are most pure when isolated through the ultracentrifugation method, but many undergraduate institutions do not have access to this equipment. The precipitation method of isolation has been shown to be effective, although it may contain some microvesicles of a slightly larger size. More detailed analysis of differing methods of exosome isolation is found in the paper listed below.